All right, so this might look like my parabola rice, but it actually isn't. A couple days ago, I successfully moved my entire rice to Void Linux. Now, I still have my parabola machine. This is actually a different computer. You'll see this is a ThinkPad X220. I still have my ThinkPad X200 with parabola, still got 100% free software. This is 99% free. I don't have a free BIOS on this, but that's another thing for another video. But I've successfully moved my rice to Void, and I'm pretty happy about it because Void, as it ends up, is a pretty nice distro. So let's talk about it really briefly. I wanted to move to this thing for a couple of reasons. One is partially just I wanted to try sort of a unique distro. Void is one of it, or one of those. It's not based on Arch or Debian or anything. Now, it's very similar to Arch. It's a rolling release. It's a minimalist install. You can install desktop environments, but I installed the minimalist variety. So it's similar to Arch in the structure. It just has runit instead of systemd. So that's something that's pretty unique. And I'll go ahead and say that in terms of even, barring all the sort of things that people say about systemd, I'm already getting the benefits of this because runit runs super fast. The boot time is extremely good. It's only a couple seconds between the BIOS menu and when you actually get to your login. So I really like that. It's actually pretty easy, just to give you an idea of how it works, right? So in systemd distros, if you want to enable a service, let's say you want to, start Network Manager whenever you boot up your computer. What you do is you just say systemctl enable Network Manager. Okay, something like that. That's how it works. Now Void is, to do the equivalent thing on Void, right? You do something a little different. You just say sudo, you make a symbolic link, and there is actually a folder in etc.cv of all the different things that you can start at startup. So if you want to start, let's say we want to add a TTY, so TTY4, which I actually don't have activated right now, you just make a symbolic link of it in the var service folder, and then just press enter. I'll put in my password, and then you can look in var service, and it should pop up. There it is. Okay. So anyway, that's pretty much the practical differences between how you do the basic things. Runit has been, I guess, a little, I don't want to say buggy, I just haven't totally figured out how to do everything in it. The logic of it is a little different than, systemd, but there you have a little more possibilities in it, so it's really nice. But aside from that, the other big thing, if you're moving from Arch to any other distro, or really if you're moving from any distro to any other distro and you want to keep your particular setup, is how do you get different, the programs you need on a daily basis to work on each distro. They all can theoretically work, but they might not be easily in the package manager. Now, Void has a package manager, xbps, x-binary package system. And it's pretty good. It has a whole lot in the repositories. But there are some things I had to install myself, but they all went pretty well. For example, the way I compile, LaTeX documents or something, the live LaTeX preview or whatever. It took a little finagling, but I did get this to work. It, of course, is not in, you don't have AUR access here, but I did install it from GitHub, and I installed a couple other things from GitHub. But sometimes you have to do a little manual configuration. Which brings me to who would I recommend Void for. I will say that if I tried to use Void, even a couple months ago, I'd be a little lost. Because there have been a couple things. I should put it this way, actually. If you're a normal user who uses, just sort of normal programs, Void's actually probably going to be okay for you. But if you are like me and you have to have a very particular configuration and a very particular rice, you might want to make sure that you know how the system actually works. And that's just because, this system actually is extremely minimalist, more so than Arch. Because a lot of the, if I want to compile a program, a C program or a Perl program or something like that, the distro by default doesn't actually come with, or do you compile Perl programs? I don't know why I said that. I don't even know. But if you, have some kind of, thing you want to compile, you might have to actually download more development tools or something like this, because a lot of things don't come with the distro by default. And there are a bunch of commands I thought were sort of basic that don't come with it. Now, that's nice if you're sort of, you know, looking for a minimalist distro, because it comes with even less than Arch or something like that. But you just have to bear in mind, because there's not that much documentation of Void yet. If you search error messages in Void, you're basically going to get more or less nothing, which you don't have very much of, but most of it is just knowing what you need to have. I'll get messages when I try and install things from GitHub sometimes, just because there won't, I need some dependency, which Void Linux doesn't install by default. So anyway, those have been sort of the problems, but overwhelmingly, my view of Void is positive. When I did the video last time, I actually got an enormous amount of positive feedback from all the, you know, all these different people saying, oh, I had used Void, and it's totally great, it's totally fantastic. So for those of you who are looking for a very Arch-similar distro that doesn't have systemd, that's just a new experience or something to sort of play around with, I definitely recommend this. But anyway, as I said before, I'm going to probably do a video on this in a little bit, but I'm using an X220, which I got very recently. I'll go over why I got one of these things. I bought it just a week ago. It was only 90 bucks. It was pretty good. But anyway, this has been a conversation about Void. So